So the Nintendo Switch is still absolutely killing it in Japan. And we found this all thanks to a Media Create update. They're one of the sales analytical places in Japan. And we discovered that the Nintendo Switch this past week sold 61,933 units, which is actually a little bit ahead, about 1,000 units ahead of the Nintendo 3DS, as you'll see in the charts in this video. And also ahead of the PlayStation 4. And this is notable because also that past week, we still had Dragon Quest XI just killing it. The 3DS version moving 260,000 units practically, and the PlayStation 4 version moving 166,000 units. But you'll see at number three is Splatoon. Splatoon. Man, look at those numbers. Look at those numbers. 87,884. Oh man, that is crazy. So we know the Nintendo Switch is essentially selling out as fast as it can. In fact, we have another report about another 3,000 plus people lining up to get their hands on Switches during a Switch lottery in Japan. And again, just proving how popular the Switch is and how its sales in Japan are actually supply constrained. The moment they put a unit on store shelves, it is gone in Japan. Period. End of story. In the United States, you might see some bundles out there. You might see a store or two that might have a unit sit there for a day. That's not the case in Japan. It is gone before those stores even open their doors. Now, moving beyond that, the Switch could be seeing some issues in the future. With the supply chain. Yes, it could get even worse. And we know the stories out there about the worldwide NAND flash, storage shortage, and that's a real thing. Like, I know it's rumored to be affecting Nintendo, but it's affecting cell phone companies, so it's definitely affecting Nintendo in some way. But now we know that another part of Nintendo's Switch could be in jeopardy. So the Wall Street Journal has reported that Japan Display, which is the exclusive provider of the screens for Nintendo Switch, slashed its workforce by about 30%. And the reason for this is because of a significant loss, something like $286 million in losses. And the big reason for this is because they used to supply screens for companies like Apple, but Apple has started to move all their products to OLED, and Japan Display only makes LCD. So with the big movement in phones going to OLED, it kind of left Japan Display in no man's land for production. And this is not good. While they still make, Nintendo Switch displays, Nintendo Switch is a very, very tiny part of what Japan Display does for the revenue streams. So if they start losing their big revenue streams, you could be talking about Japan Display potentially closing doors. Now, Japan Display is reportedly looking into potentially partnering with some people in like China and Taiwan, but at this point, it's not looking good for the company. And so Japan Display is probably looking like they're going to be closing their doors someday. Maybe this year, maybe next year, maybe it takes a few years. I don't know that Nintendo is going to have too big of an issue or how much this is going to affect Nintendo, because there are other companies, including the ones that make OLED screens, that make LCD displays. So I would assume Nintendo will be able to shift, the company that's making the screens over to another one. I don't know that this is going to potentially affect them, but if Nintendo does have a hard time getting a contract with another LCD maker, this could potentially present a problem a year or so from now, if Japan Display starts going down in the dumps. Either way, the Nintendo Switch looks like it's doing gangbusters in Japan. And while this little hiccup with the screens might present a problem someday, I think Nintendo is going to be able to work around it. There is definitely not a worldwide shortage in LCD screens, so they'll just find another manufacturer. But I am really blown away right now at how well the Switch is doing in Japan. And it might be even doing that well over here in the United States. We don't know. I know it's still really hard to get your hands on one. Finding it in supply online is nearly impossible. Finding it at retail stores is almost equally as bad. And we have no idea how many units they're even sending to the United States, considering that they want every unit they possibly can get in Japan, because, Splatoon 2 is just blowing up there. It's easily going to top a million units. And we have to worry about things like Monster Hunter Double Cross coming out, which is probably also going to top a million units next month for Japan, or this month for Japan even. So Japan's got a lot of reasons to worry about Switch production and Switch supply in Japan. And I know some people still subscribe to that theory. Nintendo is holding back stock. They are preventing people from, buying the thing to keep it sold out, to keep things looking good. I don't think so. Nintendo's not leaving money on the table. When you have thousands upon thousands of people lining up for a lottery in Japan, you think that's what Nintendo wants? They would rather have a unit for every single person that shows up because that is money left on the table. And sales of games left on the table at that. I mean, we're talking about hundreds of thousands of sales of Splatoon that could be left on the table right now just because people don't own a Switch. So I doubt that they're holding back. And the thing is, we don't know when this demand's going to slow down. I just said Monster Hunter Double Cross is coming. We have Fire Emblem Warriors coming out, which is probably going to do okay in Japan. It might be a 500,000 unit seller. And then we have Super Mario Odyssey hitting at the end of the year, which tend to, those games tend to do really well worldwide. So when you break it all down, Nintendo is doing crazy good in Japan. I'm really interested to see what the NPD is going to say about last month for Nintendo in the United States, but I assume the numbers are going to be pretty good. I don't know if it'll top PlayStation 4 because PlayStation 4 just sells really, really well in the North American region. But Switch has been making inroads, and the momentum doesn't look like it's slowing down anytime soon. And I know there's concerns out there about third-party support and getting brand new games. It's just not going to matter this year. Next year, okay. Now we're talking. Now we got to start getting those games. But this year, Nintendo almost gets a free pass because the lineup is so killer. I mean, I even haven't even brought up, Mario plus Rabbids Kingdom Battle and how that's a day one purchase for me. And I wonder how many other people are going to consider it a day one purchase too, even as it's a game created in a niche genre. It might bring new fans to that genre of games. Anyways, folks. I am Nathaniel Ruffeljantz from Nintendo Prime. If you like this video, you know what to do. If you dislike the video, hit that dislike button. Subscribe for more, and as always, folks, I will catch you in the next one.